Dubbed by some as the worst in the country's history, the first US presidential debate between Donald Trump and Joe Biden has quickly descended into an ugly sparring match filled with interruptions and insults. At times, the moderator struggled to keep control of the event, which by the end could barely be called a debate.
Billed as the political Super Bowl.
Thank you for doing this and looking forward to this, Mr. President.
Thank you, Joe.
This was more like an uncomfortable reality TV show. All theatrics and very little polish.
I want to make
sure... Mr. President, can you let him finish, sir?
No, he doesn't know how to do that. He has...
You'd
you
be
know,
surprised.
The debate fast descended into a slanging match.
Will you shut up, man?
Listen, who is on your list, Joe?
Keep yapping, man.
As the youngest man on stage, 72-year-old moderator Chris Wallace from Fox News lost control of the circus.
Folks, do you have any idea what this clown's doing?
Gentlemen, you realize if you're both speaking at the same time, please let the vice president talk. I want to move on to another subject.
But those states...
Clashing over the coronavirus pandemic, neither candidate offered any new hope.
Here, you,
Look,
it wouldn't be 200, it would be 2 million people because you were very late on the draw.
Maybe you could inject some bleach in your arm and that would take care of it. This is the
that
same man.
That was said sarcastically, that was and you know that.
The Democratic nominee attempted to connect directly with voters at home.
How many of you got up this morning and had an empty chair at the kitchen table because someone died of COVID?
Ahead in the polls, but behind on the stage, Joe Biden stumbled on the economy.
You have 91 companies, in the Fortune 500, who don't pay a single penny in tax.
While Donald Trump repeatedly tried to pull focus to the business dealings of Biden's son, Hunter.
He was thrown out, dishonorably discharged.
That's not true.
For
he wasn't dishonorably.
Cocaine use, and he didn't have a job until you became vice president.
Both men shifted blame for the protests across the country.
But are you willing tonight to condemn white supremacists and militia groups?
Sure.
Are you
I'm
prepared
to
specifically?
That, but
do it.
Well,
I would say
almost everything I see is from the left wing.
While the majority of Americans may have already decided who to support, these debates have historically impacted voter turnout. And in a race this close, encouraging even a few thousand extra people to the ballot boxes in certain states could sway the results come November.
President Trump, again, casting doubt on the process.
Will you pledge tonight that you will not declare victory until the election has been independently certified? President Trump, you go first.
I'm urging my supporters to go into the polls and watch very carefully.
America's choice tonight appears more difficult than ever before.
Okay. Gentlemen, you say that's the end of it? This is the end of this debate?
Honest ballot count.
We're going to leave it there.
In Cleveland, Ohio, Amelia Adams, 9 News.
And Charles Croucher joins me at the desk with more. Charles, what's the wash-up from this first debate?
Well, Pete, it's an estimated nearly 100 million Americans were going to tune in, and a large chunk would have tuned out. The only winners, if you could call it that, were President Xi and President Putin, as another democratic institution was trashed and America further divided by the man that's meant to unite them. Donald Trump entered the debate behind in the polls, and with very few minds changed, he will still be behind tonight. The one thing you can't get back in a campaign is time. Pete, tonight was undignified, unhelpful and unworthy of a presidential debate.
Indeed. Charles, thank you.